Hey everyone, so thank you everyone for joining. So today we have a very special session with Mukti Jain from India. She's a very young Vidwan who has been studying for some years, and she's going to be starting the study at Jaipur for Shastri. And she's going to be talking to us about all the do's and don'ts of Jain diet. So I'm not going to spend much on the intro. So I'm going to pass over to Mukti. But if anyone has any questions, if you can just use the raise your hand function. But try to keep your questions till the end, unless they're really urgent and you need to ask them in the flow of the topic, okay? But otherwise, try to keep them at the end. Okay, thank you.
Okay. Can everybody mute?
Thanks for having all of
us. Everybody mute.
Yeah. Shall we begin now? Okay. Let's do the Mangalacharan first of all. Namo Arihantanam, Namo Siddhanam, Namo Ayariyanam. नमो वचायानम् नमो लोए सवसाहुनम् कषाय की उपशांतता मात्र मोक्ष अभिलाष भवभीरु प्राणी दया यह आत्मार्थ निवास So, am I audible? I'm audible, no?
Yes.
Okay. Let's begin. We all know what culture is. We do, right? Culture isn't something that's practiced by a person or two for a restricted period of time. When generations all together practice a particular thing for hundreds and thousands of years, it is termed as culture. A single generation becomes careless and the culture is at threat. Suppose, take for example, here in India, we had the Parda culture. I think, do you know about it? Let me tell you what it is. Parda culture is something, was something. Actually, where women had to veil their faces, they couldn't, married women couldn't show their faces to the elders. Okay, and now if you come here to India, you won't see even a single woman practicing that thing. Why? Why did it happen? Because maybe some generations before us thought this culture to be unuseful or like causing inconvenience. And that is why they gave it up. They stopped practicing, they started ignoring it, and they gave it up. And resultantly, consequently, it disappeared today. There's echo happening. If you could all just mute your calls. Okay. So, maybe that culture wasn't of that significance. Maybe it was. We are not here to discuss about it. What I mean to say, what I am trying to make you understand is that if a generation or two or some people in between think a particular thing to be unuseful and start avoiding it, the culture disappears. A similar thing is happening today with us, with Jains. People have started started discarding things and started discarding culture. They are not practicing their culture. They are just living their lives there like anyone else with Jain behind, like Jain as their surname. It has just remained a surname. So, it won't do. Like we should. It's not right. What should happen, actually, we should not avoid our culture. See, do you know that in earlier times, there were crores of Jains. The population of Jains was in crores. It is said that in earlier times it was 25 crores, which now has reduced to mere 5 million, I think, 50 lakhs. Like, so negligible in comparison to what it was before. But, okay, why did it happen? Because people started feeling that Jainism isn't that necessary and it's not of that significance, and they started practicing other things, and hence they didn't remain Jain. So, and here the figures are 5 million. Well, we shouldn't concern ourselves about it, as there's nothing we can do about it. We can't repopulate the world with Jains. The real challenge that lies ahead of us is that we should ensure that the remaining Jains remain Jains. And how's that possible? Certainly, it isn't possible if we overlook our culture. If we overlook our culture, certainly these figures are going to reduce further. And there will be a time when there will be no Jains. No one will know what Jains are. Let us discuss about one such practice, which is on a verge of extinction, I should say, that makes us a Jain. First of all, do you know that some philosophies and culture, like mostly Western philosophies and culture, say that jivo jivasya bhajanam, jivo jivasya bhakshanam. What does it mean? कि एक जीव दूसरे जीव के लिए बना है, like some disturbances happening.
तुमने देखा हो क्यों देखा
हो? One minute.
If we don't do something,
everybody mute, please.
I think the host can mute them all.
There's no, I can't see the mute everybody. Can somebody help me out?
I think if you click on participants, you can do it there.
Should I continue?
Simone,
except me, so I was saying ki Western philosophies, some cultures say that jivo jivasya bhajanam, jivo jivasya bhakshanam. It means that ek jeev dusre jeev ke liye bana hai. Like one jeev can eat another, and if one wants, one can kill another. So that's what their philosophy says. On the contrary, our Jain philosophy says कि कोई किसी के लिए नहीं बना है. Everything is for itself, right? It exists for itself. Nothing exists for some other thing. No one and nothing has right over anything other. As for us, we don't have right on any other lives. And that is why we don't consume meat, and we are vegetarians, and we Jain culture actually is considered to be a very strict and pious one. So that's what it is. Now, we actually, as I have said, that we should not kill other organisms. We have no right over others' lives. But since we can't live without certain things, we as humans, like we need certain things for our survival, like eating food, drinking water, even breathing. All these things cause the harm to organisms. Though we can't see them, but it causes harm to organisms. But there are some things where violence can't be avoided. And there are certain ways in which it can be. And we should try our best to avoid the violence as much as we can. Right? So, here it is, water filtration. Its significance, how it is to be done, we'll discuss it all. First of all, let's take an incident. You might have heard of a Panditji, a Vidwan, named Pandit Gopal Das Ji Paraiya. Maybe you haven't. He was a great Jain scholar. He has even written some granths, like scriptures. One of his famous scriptures, which is read across the world, is Jain Siddhant Praveshika, in which he has written things in question and answer form, which are so easy to understand. So, yes, and made our task much easier. So, that's written by Pandit Gopal Das Ji Paraiya. He, once in Calcutta, was delivering a speech on water filtration. He was motivating people that they should drink filtered water. In that speech, he stated that a single drop of unfiltered water has countless organisms in it. And in that crowd, in that huge audience, was also present a scientist, great scientist named Jagdish Chandra Bose. Who doesn't know him in India? Everyone does. He was present there and he, inspired by speech of Panditji, he made a discovery that a single drop, he made a scientific discovery with the use of equipments and all, that a single drop of unfiltered water contains 36,450 organisms in it. Recently, there had been a study in University of Sweden in which they revealed that a single milliliter of unfiltered water has 80,000 bacteria in it. See, these scientific figures can't entirely be relied upon. As we all know, that vision of scientific eye flickers every now and again. They are saying something today, they'll say something else tomorrow. They'll say that the discovery we made 9 years ago was all false and wasn't true. So it can't entirely be relied upon, but it gives us a brief idea. Like several studies have proved, so it gives us a brief idea that organisms do exist in water, right, in unfiltered water. But the scientific figures can't be trusted. But what Bhagwan has said, what Kevali Bhagwan has said, what our Sarvagya Bhagwan has said, doesn't ever change. Infinite years ke baad, if we go to any samav sharan, if we ask any Tirthankar ki kitne jeev hote hain, the answer will be same as it was anant saal pehle, infinite years before. Yes, it won't ever change. Never. So, yes, that's what can be relied upon. And what Bhagwan has said is that a single drop of unfiltered water has countable tras jeev and uncountable sthavar jeevs in it. Now, for those who don't know what tras and sthavar are, tras is two or more sensed organisms, and sthavars are one sensed organisms. By saying this, like those who only have sense of touch are one sensed organisms, and those who have sense of smell, those who can see, and like those who can smell, all those. So these are other tras jeevs. So what Bhagwan has said is, a single drop of unfiltered water has countable tras jeevs and uncountable sthavar jeevs in it. Now, you might wonder how a single drop of water contains all that stuff. So, the scholars have said that they are so small, the organisms are so small, they certainly aren't visible to our naked eyes. We think the water is clear, but it's not. And even the scientific discoveries, thousands of scientific discoveries won't ever result to this discovery ki it has this many organisms. But this is what Bhagwan has said. Scholars say that if the organisms in that water blow up to the size of rai ka dana, you know rai ka dana, mustard seed, if they blow up to that size, we all know how small it is, right? But still, if they blow up to that size, they can fill the entire Jambudvip up. Now, what Jambudvip is, for now, the world that we live in, the world science says is world, is only like a point on a whole circle as compared to the whole circle. It is like very tiny part of Jambudvip. So Jambudvip is so big, and that Jambudvip can be filled up if organisms in one single drop blow, like they become big. So it's a matter we should think about. If we still, after knowing all this, if we still drink unfiltered water, what should we be called? This matter needs deliberation. Actually, an Acharya, Acharya Dev Singh, in his scripture, Savai Dhamma, writes, Jena agalyu jalupiyai, jani jaina pavanu, jotam aga piyai agalyu, so dhivarah pahanu. What does it mean? Dhivar, the word that was in shlok, that was in gatha, dhivar. Dhivar means fisherman. And pahan, pahan stands for pradhan. Pradhan is main, the leader. Right? So what Acharya says is, if Acharya says that the one who drinks unfiltered water does not follow Jain order, and the one who drinks unfiltered water is leader of the fishermen. By saying this, he means to say that he is even more cruel than fishermen. We all know what fishermen does, kills fishes, and we all blame him for that, blame fishermen for that. But shouldn't we be blamed? Like, we being Jains, it says he does that for livelihood, right? He has no other option, we can say. But we do have option, we know things, and if we still consume such water filled with organisms, what should we be called? We are killing all of them. So only when we see that water, unfiltered water, as a cluster of organisms, a cluster of dead bodies, pile of dead bodies, and their blood dissolved in it, though it is invisible to our eyes, but it does exist there. Only when we see this can we abandon using it. The gatha I told you, a similar gatha comes in a non-Jain scripture named Ling Puran. There Acharya has said that samvatsarena yat papam kurute matsya vedakah ekahena tahapnoti aputa jalasankuli. What does it mean? It means samvatsar is an year, right? Samvatsarena yat papam, ki ek year mein jo pap kurute karta hai, kon matsya vedakah. Matsya vedak is a fisherman. Kya ki ek fisherman machliya mar mar ke, fishes mar mar ke, ek saal mein jitna pap karta hai, utna pap to ekahin matlab ek din mein hi, in a single day, kar leta hai. Kon jo aput jal sankuli, जो अनछना पानी पीता है, जो अनफिल्टर्ड वाटर पीता है, मतलब जितना पाप, जितना सिन, जितना वायलेंस एक फिशरमैन पूरे साल में मछलियां मार मार के करता है, उससे ज्यादा पाप तो एक नॉर्मल इंसान जो अनफिल्टर्ड वाटर पीता है वो एक दिन में ही कर लेता है. इतने सारे ऑर्गेनिजम्स होते हैं अनफिल्टर्ड वाटर में. ओके, सो दिस इज व्हाट scriptures had to say about the people who drink unfiltered water, right? Now let's have a scientific view. We know that Jain philosophy has time and again been revalidated by scientists as being holistic, compassionate, and good for health. Right? So, there was this Dr. Masaru Emoto of Japan, who by studying thousands of things, thousands of scientific previous discoveries and all, he came to a conclusion yes, Dr. Emoto of Japan, right? He says that water-bodied organisms have some capability to exchange energy. So basically, the conclusion is water-being organisms exist as living beings, and they should be protected. What do our scriptures have to say about this? They say that jalkayik jeev, water-bodied organisms, have a lifespan ranging from an antarmuhurt, which is 48 minutes, to 7,000 years. Like, they can live up to that lifespan, right? They have a lifespan that big. So, scholars say that... okay, fine. That's what it is. So what should we do? We should use filtered water, because we have seen that unfiltered water is a living organism, shouldn't be harmed. What to do next? We should drink filtered water. Now, what do you think of when I said filtered water? Did the idea of demineralized or RO water occur to you? Did you think of that? See, there are some reasons why we should straight away abandon the use of demineralized and RO water. First of all, the main motive of our debate, like all of our discussion, is that main motive is Jeev Daya. Meha ji, yes. Jai Jinendra, you can ask questions, but can you wait for some time? So
okay,
once
sure,
the session
sure,
is over.
Yeah. Sure, yes, we will wait.
Yes. We'll have a question and answer session afterwards. So yes.
Thank you.
Okay. Yes, so I was saying, the main motive of our discussion is Jeev Daya. We are figuring out the ways to, we are finding out how we can reduce the violence and how we can save other organisms like us. By that I don't mean that we are consuming human beings or and all, but what I'm saying is the organisms that are present in that unfiltered water have the life, their value, their life is of same value. Like, it shouldn't be valued less. So that's why I said that organisms like us, and that's why we should save them. We are devising the ways, we are finding out the ways to save them. And this purpose of ours is not fulfilled if we consume, will not be fulfilled if we consume demineralized or RO water. Why? Because the organisms present in it die during the process itself. RO water passes through 5 or 6 layers, like as what I know, and demineralized water maybe aise kuch process hota hoga. So the organisms die before coming to us. In that case, if we are consuming that water, all that we will be consuming will be corpses, right? And certainly we don't want to do that. Do we want to drink dead bodies? No, we don't want to do that. So what should be done then? Scholars say that drishtiputam nyaset padam patputam jalam pibe. It means that dekh dekh ke chalo aur kapde se chhan kar pani piyo. Aur ek acharya ka apan dekhte hain. Vastrena tisu pinena galitam tat pibe jalam hinsa vrit rakshaye mans doshaye nodane. It means that the one who wants to follow ahimsa and who wants to avoid the pap of eating meat should not drink unfiltered water. That person should filter water using a cloth. Now, what's the process of water filtration? Can you please mute Janav? Yes, whatever you are, I'm so sorry, Janav ji. So, I was saying, link to jata hai. Let's discuss the process of water filtration. First of all, I just said that water should be filtered using cotton clothes. What is it? Now that we have decided to drink filtered water, let's move ahead. Take a cotton cloth, which should be so thick that which should be so thick that if we hold it against the sun, right? If the cloth, if we hold it against the sun, the sun rays shouldn't pass. Like we shouldn't be able to see the sun rays directly. So the cloth should be that thick, and the cloth should be made up of pure cotton. The material shouldn't, like no other material should be mixed in it, and it should be pure cotton. By that I mean khadi. It should be khadi, and it should be white. There should be no dyed, like it shouldn't be dyed with any colors, dyed or bleached with any colors, right? By white I mean that it actually has yellowish tinge in it. The khadi cloth, that's what its actual color is. So that's what how a cotton filter should be. Now, the cloth through which we are filtering the water should be thrice the diameter of the opening of the vessel in which the water is to be filled. Thrice the diameter. Why am I saying that? Because actually, however thick a cloth is, we can't filter water using a single layered cloth. Otherwise, it won't be considered as filtered water. So, what is to be done? We have to double the cloth, make it double layered. Then we should put it on the vessel, or we can tie it to the faucet, like whatever is convenient to us. And the water should be filled. So, if it is thrice the diameter, and if you keep it on the vessel, it will be good. Otherwise, it may slip off and all your water will become unfiltered again, and you will have to do all that again, right? So you have to take thrice the cloth thrice the diameter. It has been written in the scriptures. So yes, and also we should know that the main thing is factually we should drink water drawn from the wells. Wells, kuwe se khicha hua pani peena chahiye. But since wells aren't available, like bahut kam logon ne wells dekhi hogi, right? Aur practicality keeps us from doing so. So we can, the best option that seems to us is drinking water from tube wells. We can opt that option if we aren't, if we don't have well in like nearby. So we can drink water from tube wells, but we should filter it before drinking. And if you are living in a place where there is a well, ja kua hai, so you should go for well, but I don't think any of us is that lucky, right? So okay, the water should be like that. Then we have doubled the cloth, we have kept it on the vessel. Once we are done filling the water, the filter like this might be a slow process, because the cloth we took was so thick, right? And after that we made it double layered, so it is a slow process, but we have to wait. That's the only way to filter water. So once the water gets filled, always filter more water than we need. Thoda sa jada. Why? Let's see why. Once we are done filtering water, take that cloth to some water outlet, like from where the water drains. And we should make sure that that outlet also has its outlet somewhere in water resource, so that the organisms in it don't die. There are certain organisms which can live in water only. They won't live in dried conditions. If we see, let us first of all look at the process, then I will explain it to you. Then once we bring it there, we should pour some water on the cloth from which we filtered water, right? So jis side se humne water filter kiya, us side bhi, uske ulte side bhi, and dhyan rakho, we are using double layered cloth. So we should make it single layered, we should open it, and uske bhi dono side se we should pour some water. Isse kya hoga ki जो जीव थे ना उस पर, ऑर्गेनिजम्स थे ना क्लॉथ पर, द ऑर्गेनिजम्स दैट वर रिमेनिंग ऑन द क्लॉथ, दे विल गो टू द वाटर आउटलेट, लाइक दे विल गो टू द वाटर आउटलेट वंस वी पोर वाटर ऑन दैट, एंड दे कैन सर्वाइव दैट वे. सो दैट्स व्हाट वी शुड डू. एंड ओके, सो एंड do you know that when we filter water, we filter thrush jeeves? What are thrush jeeves? I told it before, that two or more sensed living organisms. So jab hum pani chhante hain, to jo one sensed living organisms hai na, they don't get filtered, they don't remain on the cloth, they come along with the filtered water. But the ones that remain on the surface are thrush jeeves. And why should we do so? Why should we only save thrush jeeves? Because thrush jeeves, it is written in scriptures that exceptionally we can use, we shravaks, like we are living at home and there is no survival possible without certain things. So it is allowed for us to do hinsa of one indriya jeev, sthavar jeeves, but we can't kill two or more indriya jeeves, like not intentionally, not unintentionally. So we shouldn't do that. And when we filter water, we save two or more indriya jeeves. So that's what is to be done. Now, once we are, the process that we did, that we just did, what was it? Like we poured water on the cotton cloth. So this process is known as bilchani or jivani. So aisa kehte ki jivani de do, bilchani de do. So and is the most important part of water filtering process. Most important. Many people don't do that. They filter water, kehte hum pee to rahe hai, fir baakiyon ka kya hota hai, pee to filtered hi rahe. No. It doesn't matter. We have to save the organisms. तो फिर तो मतलब ही नहीं रहा, वो वैसे भी मरने थे, ऐसे भी मरने थे. तो मेन पार्ट ऑफ द प्रोसेस इज बिलछानी, एंड वी शुड डू दैट, राइट? नाउ the process isn't over yet. Pani chhan ke ho gaya. But what happens if we don't make the water maryadit? I will tell what maryada is. The organisms will start popping up again after 48 minutes. Huh? So making the water unfiltered and undrinkable again. So what should be done? We should make it maryadit. Maryada is a span for which the water, for which organisms don't revive in the water. So how can it be done? See, there are many ways to do so. If we put clove or fennel seed or pomegranate peel in unfiltered, like, sorry, not in unfiltered water, in filtered water that we just filtered. Huh? If we put that in it, the maryada, the maryada of water extends to 6 hours. That is ka matlab kya ki we can drink that water for 6 hours. And instead of doing all this, we can just make it a bit warm. That will do the same thing. It will be maryadit for 6 hours, drinkable for 6 hours. Then if we heat it a bit more, make it a bit more warm, like warmer, not actually boil it, but if we make it a bit more warm, it, the maryada will extend up to 12 hours, making the water drinkable for 12 hours. And if we, it will be over soon. If we boil the water, maryada will be over. I couldn't understand your question, whatever it was. I'll repeat it again. Okay.
Trying to say maryada is the time limit. Time span is increased by putting...
Maryada, time span is increased by 12 hours or 24 hours. Now, if we boil the water, the bubbles start appearing in that, agar itna boil kar lete hain, to maryada extends for the time limit, extends for 24 hours, making the water drinkable for 24 hours. Now, what happens after, why should we boil the water actually? Boiling the water indeed does kill the onesest living organisms in it. Okay, then why boil it if they are going to die? So we should boil it because once we boil the water, for ek bar, the organisms will die. The sthavar organisms that were remaining after filtration of water, one-sensed organisms. They will die, but they will not crop up again for certain period of time. Utni maryada jitni boli hai na, utne time ke liye they will not revive, they will not crop up. And after that, of course, wo wapis revive honge, but for that period, wo nahi aayenge. Or agar, if we don't boil the water, what will happen? Like if we don't make it maryadit, or if we don't boil the water, they will start the reproduction goes on of those. They keep on multiplying actually. So when we boil the water, we just stop them from multiplying. Hence reducing the sin. Jo paap hoga, violence hoga, wo ek hi baar hoga, and after that, koi violence nahi hoga. Utne time ke liye. Aur agar hum maryada nahi karte hain, to wo sin violence hota rahega. So it is the best option to boil the water. Now, even keeping in mind its benefits, it has many benefits on health. So many physicians and doctors also prescribe drinking hot water. So the thing to be remembered is once the maryada of water is over, time span for which jitna humne boil kiya tha, agar wo 12 hours ke jitna boil kiya tha, once it is over, we can't refilter it. we shouldn't drink it, of course, and we can't even refilter the same water once the maryada is over. Kyunki what happens, jab hum pehli baar filter karte hain to thrush ji muh par reh jate hain and we can save them that way. But after once the maryada is over, different kind of organisms like revive, they are born in it. So which can't actually be filtered through cotton filter. So we shouldn't refilter the same water once the maryada is over. Of course, if this is the case ki aapne water, if you have filtered the water and if you have forgotten to do its maryada and it exceeds the time limit of 48 minutes, right? So in that case you can refilter the water. Jab agar aapne kisi bhi कोई भी तरह की मर्यादा नहीं की हो उसकी, ना आपने कोई बॉयल किया हो, ना आपने उसमें पोमोग्रेनेट पील वगैरह डाला हो, इन दैट केस यू कैन रीफिल्टर इट. बट एक बार अगर आप मर्यादा कर लेते हैं वाटर की, सो यू कांट रीफिल्टर इट अगेन. दिस पॉइंट इज टू बी केप्ट इन माइंड. मेनी पीपल डू दिस थिंग, दे से कोई बात नहीं, वी विल रीफिल्टर दिस वाटर. नो, दिस शुडंट बी डन. नाउ this isn't all, this discussion isn't only about drinking filtered water, it is also about using filtered water. The water that we use for taking bath, the water we use for washing clothes, for cooking food, for any other thing, it should be filtered. Why? Ki hinsa jo hoti hai, jo violence hota hai, wo sirf पानी पीने से थोड़ी ना होता है, वो तो इन एवरी एक्टिविटी टू डू वी डू वायलेंस हैपेंस. सो वी शुड यूज फिल्टर्ड वाटर एज वेल, वी शुडंट ओनली ड्रिंक फिल्टर्ड वाटर, वी शुड यूज फिल्टर्ड वाटर एज वेल. द वाटर वी यूज इन वॉशरूम्स, इट शुडंट बी लाइक डायरेक्ट वाटर. इसीलिए ऑल्सो द फ्लशेस दैट वी यूज, लाइक नॉट फ्री दैट पीपल यूज, right, they shouldn't be used because it's all unfiltered water, all the organisms die. There are alternatives to do this, like, oh, of course a bit effort taking, but we should do that. Agar hame paap nahi kamana hai, if we, how does boiled water last for a long time? That's how it happens. If we boil it for the organisms don't revive. Hey, aisa hi hai. Like there is no reason behind that. Aisa hi hai ki wo ho jata hai us tarah ka ki usme nahi hote wapas. So there was this question from someone that I just answered. Okay. Now, वैसे we will have question answer session once the session is over. So okay. Use of flushes. Geysers is not apt, right? In geysers what happens, water gets boiled of course, but uske pehle jo humne jo thrust steam hata liye the in the case of filtration, right, the two or more sensed organisms jo humne hata liye the, it doesn't happen in that case. To fir sare jeev mar jayenge. So if we want to like use hot water for any other use, any other thing, we should first of all filter it and then boil it. There are other ways to do that. We can use heating rods, we can heat it on the induction, or many other ways, you all know that. So we should go for these alternatives. Yes, and usage of electricity should also be reduced. Ye to bolte hi hain, everyone says that use of electricity should be reduced. कि बहुत शॉर्टेज है और बहुत रिसोर्सेस वेस्ट होते हैं, वो तो होते ही है. यू इफ यू आर नॉट डूइंग सो यू आर ओके, आई विल आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन लेटर. देयर इज अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम समवन, आई विल आंसर दैट लेटर. यस, आई वाज सेइंग, यस, द ये तो सब कहते ही है कि पावर जनरेशन में बहुत सारे रिसोर्सेस लगते हैं, कंट्री का बहुत नुकसान होता है एंड ऑल. सो वो तो करना ही चाहिए, लेकिन अगर आप गवर्नमेंट की ज्यादा नहीं सुनते हो, सो लिसन टू व्हाट भगवान हैज टू से, राइट? जो पावर जनरेशन होता है, आजकल हमारी लाइफ ऐसी हो गई है दैट वी कांट इमेजिन आवर लाइफ विदाउट ऑल दीज थिंग्स, विदाउट फैंस एंड एसीज एंड लाइट्स एंड ऑल. बट ऑल वी कैन डू इज वी कैन रिड्यूस द यूज ऑफ देम, कांट वी? वी कैन. सो वी शुड यूज इट जितना नेसेसरी हो, बिकॉज उसमें भी जो पावर जनरेशन में भी द वॉटर यूज इज अनफिल्टर्ड एंड विच कॉजेस वायलेंस. So we should reduce that too, and we should think about it. We should think of other ways to reduce the violence and other ways to use filtered water. Now, this practice, drinking of unfiltered, drinking of filtered water, keeps us from consumption of abhakshya market products as well, right? Bahar jaake kuch bhi kha liya. अगर सी हाउ सिंगल वाव कीप्स अस अवे फ्रॉम ऑल दिस न्यूमरस पाप्स, कि बहुत सारे पाप बच जाते हैं अगर हम एक सिंगल वाटर फिल्ट्रेशन की वाव लेते हैं. कल्चर का प्रिजर्वेशन होता है तो होता ही है, प्लस बहुत सारे पाप बचते हैं एंड वी कैन सेव आवरसेल्व्स फ्रॉम सिंस. सो अभक्ष्य मार्केट प्रोडक्ट्स, बाप रे उनका तो क्या ही कहना. अब वी डोंट हैव दैट मच ऑफ टाइम, दैट्स नॉट आवर सब्जेक्ट टुडे, क्योंकि इसमें बोलने को तो इतना है ना. अभक्ष्य मार्केट प्रोडक्ट्स जिसपे ग्रीन सिंबल रहता है, एक मैगजीन आती है चहकती चेतना, उसकी तरफ से एक पैम्फलेट आया था बीच में, बहुत चला, ग्रीन सिंबल का सच. वो क्या करते हैं, दे ओनली एक्सक्लूड मीट एंड दे से दैट दिस इज लाइक, दे पुट ग्रीन सिंबल ऑन इट एंड दे many a times they include many other things like bones and all, and they say that it's like they put a green symbol on it and we think that it's all consumable and we eat that. So what I am discussing about is ye kuch hota ho ki nahi hota ho, jo market products hote hain they are not edible. So agar hum ye vow lete hain to hum market products of course use nahi karenge, kyunki market products jitne bhi honge usme unfiltered water to use hoga hi. To hame hum in is paap se bhi bach jayenge, hum ko bas filtered water use karna chahiye. Now let's have a glimpse at an incident from past. There was this boy named Jinsen, okay? He was almost 5 years old. Once he and his mother were strolling past a river in the city, and they were going by when the child, he was 5 years old, he saw a soldier beheading a man. बहुत पहले की बात है. तो ही सॉ सोल्जर बिहेडिंग अ मैन. ही आस्क्ड हिज मदर, उसकी मम्मी ने कहा लीव इट, नन ऑफ योर कंसर्न. उस ऑन बीइंग पर्सुएडेड हिज मदर सेड दैट सन, दिस पर्सन हु वाज बिहेडेड राइट नाउ वाज अ जैन. ही वाज बिहेडेड बिकॉज ही वाज फिल्टरिंग वाटर, एंड वाटर फिल्ट्रेशन इज एन आईडी कार्ड ऑफ जैन, right? And the ruler that ruled at that time, he despised Jains, he did not like Jains, and he got Jains killed wherever he saw them. So all these practices of water filtration and dev darshan, they were all prohibited at that time. So this incident clearly because at the importance of water filtration, ki jisko Jains ka ID card samjha jata hai, अगर आज हम वो छोड़ते हैं तो वी आर लूजिंग आवर आइडेंटिटी, aren't we? सो वी शुड ड्रिंक फिल्टर्ड वाटर, एंड इफ यू आर नॉट डूइंग सो वी आर फेलिंग आवर एंसेस्टर्स हु स्ट्राइव सो हार्ड टू कीप दिस मॉरल्स इंटैक्ट एंड हु वांटेड अस टू फॉलो देम. इफ यू आरंट डूइंग सो वी आर फेलिंग देम, सो वी शुड फॉलो दीज थिंग्स. नाउ we do all this, we should do all this indeed. Jaini कोई भी जैन एक बूंद भी अनछना पानी पीता नहीं, और छना पानी पीकर उसमें एक बूंद भी धर्म मानता नहीं। मतलब क्या? धर्म इज समथिंग एल्स। ऑल दिस देव दर्शन, पूजन एंड वाटर फिल्ट्रेशन, ऑल दीज थिंग्स हैपन, दे शुड हैपन एज लॉन्ग एज वी आर एंगेज इन एक्टिविटीज, वी शुड एंगेज इन गुड एक्टिविटीज। बट द मेन थिंग टू डू इज टू द मेन थिंग इज टू लीव ऑल दीज। ये सब धर्म नहीं है। What is dharma? Recognizing oneself. That recognizing that I am a soul and I am not the doer of things. Recognizing this is the main thing. This is the dharma. All these water filtration and all, this is not dharma. This is part of the process. Right? So, हाँ, तो ये सब चीजें जो होती है वॉटर फिल्ट्रेशन एंड ऑल, या हमें परमिशन देता है, लाइसेंस देता है आगे बढ़ने का। अगर हम इतना भी फॉलो नहीं करेंगे तो आगे बढ़ना एंड भगवान बनना एंड ऑल, ये सब बड़ी बड़ी चीजें तो छोड़ ही दो, राइट? इफ यू कैन डू इवन दिस, इससे तो बस एक परमिशन मिल जाती है, ओके इफ यू आर फॉलोइंग दिस देन यू कैन मूव अहेड, बट इफ यू आर नॉट इवन फॉलोइंग दिस यू कांट मूव अहेड। So this is the basic thing, primary thing we should do, but we should not settle for this. We should move ahead. We should recognize ourselves and jagrit pragya chaini vehi sachche jaini. Ki jinki pragya chaini, jinko samyak gyan hai, jinka gyan jagrit ho gaya hai, matlab jinko samyak gyan, they are true jains. And फिर व्यवहार से बोल देते हैं, व्यवहार कहने के लिए बोल देते हैं कि जो पिए छान कर पानी वे ही सच्चे जैनी, जो देव दर्शन करे वे ही सच्चे जैनी। बट द मेन थिंग इज जो सम्यक दृष्टि है, लाइक द वन हु हैज रिकॉग्नाइज्ड वनसेल्फ एज अ ट्रू सोल, एज अ प्योर सोल, इज अ ट्रू जैन। वेल वी आर डन नाउ द क्वेश्चन, और या फिर कुछ समझ में नहीं आया हो तो ओके। देयर वाज दिस क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम शीतल जी शाह, व्हाट इज अल्टरनेटिव टू फ्लशिंग टॉयलेट? वी डू, वी फिल द बकेट्स विद फिल्टर्ड वाटर एंड वी मेक इट मर्यादित, वी आइदर वी बॉइल इट और वी पुट सम पोमोग्रेनेट पील और सो इन इट, and then we lift that bucket up and do the same thing as the flush does. So in that way it gets cleaned. Fine. We shouldn't you might find it disgusting, but it's not, because it's the cost is not more than the prior thing is to save the organisms, and we should all leave all these things aside. Ki kaisa lagega, bura lagega. No, we should do the right thing, and the right thing is, the only way to do this is, we can't filter the whole lot that comes in that flushing wala unit. So, hum water filter karke bucket se pour kar sakte hain. That's the way. Now, any other questions?
Yeah, Mukti ji, you said yes. That tube well se pani lekar you can filter it, that is usse maryada badh jayegi, but the water we get already at the moment, what every in cities, towns, is already the trust you have been killed.
Oh, isn't there any water from tube well and all? Isn't there any option?
From a reservoir, it goes to the water company, and the water company will give the water to us, running tap water, right? And the amount of times it's been filtered over there is maybe 10s, 20 times. So everything has been killed already. So what is the point of filtering water when you get it from the tap? That's my question.
Okay, now that's the thing. at least. I think we are lucky enough to have water from tube wells so that we can filter. But in case you don't have that option, you can't save the organisms, right? But you can just filter the corpses off. You can filter the dead bodies off. So they maybe, won't come in your consumption. You won't.
Maybe I will be able to answer that. I will be able to answer that question. Yes. Because I think Muktiji mentioned about the 24 minutes maryada, right? Ek ghadi ni maryada hoy.
24 hours, actually.
24 hours when it is heated up. So when we receive water from our water reservoir, it's not heated water, right? It's not boiled water. They just filter it using the chemicals like chlorine to clean it up for certain section of bacteria, not everything. I think the Jainism principle mentions if you use cloth as a filtering mechanism, we have an assurity at the time of drinking or consuming the water, we are assuring that we are removing the bacteria as much as possible. Okay?
Right.
Hope that helps. Okay.
Thanks.
Thank you.
That's what it is. Huh. Now, anything else? Can filter it from water bottles. Water bottles. The water from water bottles isn't actually drinkable. And it's all, I think, canned water, demineralized water, RO water. Now, that's the question. Agar water bottles mein bhi wahi same water aata ho jo aapke yahan taps mein aata hai. Now, I can't say anything else. But we can do the best thing possible. We can filter it. Right? First of all, the pehli thing to hai ki if we can, like, achhi jagah aisi dhoonde jahan par hum ye sab palan kar sake. Isliye granthon mein aata hai ki ki videshon mein ye sab problem hoti hai. So agar if we, like, chota muh badi baat na ho jaye, lekin paise ke liye wahan se यहाँ से वहां गए, धर्म के लिए वहां से यहाँ अगर आ सकते हैं हम, तो वी शुड डू दैट. इट्स हाँ ठीक है. एंड व्हाट वाज आई सेइंग, आई एक्चुअली वांटेड टू से समथिंग एल्स. ओके फाइन आई जस्ट फॉरगॉट. व्हेन आई रिमेंबर आई विल टेल इट. द क्वेश्चन इज what are alternative options for making maryadit? You mentioned pomegranate peel. Are there others? And what time maryada do they provide? Okay, there are others. As I mentioned, you can put long. Long is clove. And fennel seed, soft, dal sakte hai. Or any such thing. Actually, pata hai kya aata hai ki जिस फिल्टर से हम पानी छानते हैं ना, एक बार हम उसको उसको बिलछानी दे देते हैं अगर. हाँ राइट यू आर राइट. शीतल दीदी सेज दैट एनीथिंग दैट चेंज द टेस्ट ऑफ वाटर स्लाइटली. एनीथिंग एक्चुअली एनीथिंग दैट चेंजेस द टेस्ट एंड कलर ऑफ वाटर स्लाइटली मेक्स द वाटर maryadit. It provides the maryada time limit of 6 hours. And actually, हाँ, तो I was saying कि जो छन्ना रहता है ना, उसी को एक बार बिलछानी हो जाए और once the water stops trickling, right? Once the water stops trickling, तो उसको ही हम उस पानी में डाल सकते हैं and उसी में like क्या कर सकते, रिंस करके और उसको निचोड़ सकते उसी में. तो उससे भी ऐसा ही हो जाता, बहुत लोग करते हैं इसको ऐसे. या फिर कोई सा भी अच्छा कपड़ा लेके और उसको उस पानी में अच्छे से डाल लो, तो क्या हो जाता है, थोड़ा सा टेस्ट और कलर चेंज हो जाता है, मैला सा कलर दिखने लगता है जरूर थोड़ा. सो शुड वी ऑल्सो गिव फिल्टर्ड वाटर टू प्लांट्स? इनडीड, इफ यू आर प्लांटिंग देम यू शुड गिव फिल्टर्ड. Of course. वैसे हाँ, ऐसे मैंने इसलिए बोला क्योंकि जेंट्स को क्या किसी को भी नहीं रखने चाहिए, लेकिन मानेगा कौन? तो जेंट्स को प्लांट्स रखने ही नहीं चाहिए घर पे. उसको लेकर प्लांट्स एक्चुअली क्या होता है, मेन थिंग, मेन पर्पज है, अगर आपको लगाना ही है कुछ तो आप पेड़ लगा सकते हैं, इतनी जगह है घर पे. तो द पर्पज इट सर्व्स इट इज कि आपको उससे लाइक स्क्रिप्चर्स में आता है कि मेन पर्पज उसका एक छाया, छाया इज लाइक यू गेट शेडो और वेन एवर यू फील एनवायरमेंट अच्छा रहता है, बहुत सारे वो है फायदे. एंड फ्रूट्स होते हैं राइट. अब प्लांट्स जो होते हैं छोटे छोटे शो के लिए लगा देते हैं, इट्स नॉट राइट, क्योंकि उसके उसको लेकर जीव उत्पत्ति होती है और इतना केयर फिर करना, उसके पीछे टाइम खराब करना, जीव उत्पत्ति होती है, उसकी हिंसा का दोष भी हमें लगता है. तो व्हाई डू ऑल दिस? बट एट ऑल इफ यू आर डूइंग दिस यू शुड यूज फिल्टर्ड वाटर जो भी कर रहे हो. सो यस आई एम डन.
Okay, anybody has any more questions? So we will see Mukti ji tomorrow. Thank you for today's session, very enlightening.
Hey, Shital, hi. Hi. I have a couple of questions if I can ask.
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. The first question is, how do you recognize the five Udambar phal? Okay, and what are their English names?
I got your questions, sir. Udambar phals. Now, how do we recognize them actually? After you ask questions, I refer to some texts, right? इस session में मुझे लगा हो नहीं पाएगा, but still I did. तो उसमें था, first of all, मैं बताना चाहूंगी कि उदंबर फल को संस्कृत डिक्शनरी में नाम है जंतु फल. जंतु फल मीन्स जंतु इज ऑर्गेनिज्म. तो जंतु फल ये संस्कृत डिक्शनरी में नाम है, इट्स नॉट अबाउट जैन स्क्रिप्चर. तो उदंबर फल शुडंट बी कंज्यूम. नाउ हाउ डू वी रिकॉग्नाइज देम? उदंबर फल जो होते हैं वो बिना फ्लावर के सीधे ग्रो होते हैं ब्रांचेस पर, उस अनलाइक अदर फ्रूट्स. क्योंकि अदर फ्रूट्स के पहले व्हाट हैपेंस, द फ्लावर्स ग्रो फर्स्ट एंड आफ्टर दैट द फ्रूट कम्स. But in case of Udambar fruits, there is no flower before that. So that's what we call Udambar fruits. And scriptures mein isko jackfruit and aajkal pineapple. Iska pineapple ka to scriptures mein kuch aata nahi hai kyunki ye aajkal ka fruit hai. But still pineapple bhi consume nahi karna chahiye. Ye bhi Udambar phal ki category mein aata hai. Jackfruit hai, wo bhi Udambar phal ki category mein aata hai. Figs hai, anjeer. फिग तो वो भी उदंबर फल है. बाकी तो बहुत ज्यादा देखने में नहीं है, ऑफ कोर्स दे डू एग्जिस्ट बाकी के उदंबर फल, लेकिन बहुत ज्यादा देखने में नहीं है हमारे. एंड यू आस्क्ड अबाउट इंग्लिश नेम्स, आई ट्राइड टू सर्च देम बट आई कुडंट फाइंड देम. तो जैक फ्रूट है और पाइन एप्पल है जो जो डाली तोड़ के आते हैं.
Okay, I don't understand the reason for the pineapple. I understand the jackfruit and all that, but I don't understand the reason why pineapple is. Go on.
Okay. Pineapple, bhi, I think it comes without the flower. Like flower doesn't grow before that, right?
I don't know.
It doesn't. Okay. I've heard that it doesn't. I've heard many a times that flower doesn't grow before pineapple. So it should, and it many scholars say that it has the same, like they are of the same variety, Udambar fruits and pineapple, so it shouldn't be consumed.
Okay. I've got another question. Someone sent me a clip, an audio clip, saying that if you mix mustard and salt, then trasjeev become spontaneously they arise. Is that true? Because there was no Shastra reference. True. Is there a Shastra reference?
Shastra reference for Rai and Nama?
Oh, yes. Salt, yeah.
I'll look for it and I'll let you know. There indeed is a Shastra reference for it. And actually, you know, the ek Dvidal ka prakaran hai, मैं अभी थोड़ी देर में सर्च करके आपको बता सकती हूँ. एक द्विदल का प्रकरण है, द्विदल नाम का टॉपिक है. द्विदल में क्या होता है, यू कांट, आई टेल दैट आफ्टरवर्ड्स, राइट. हाँ, सो उसमें क्या होता है कि द्विदल में दूध के साथ आप पर्टिकुलर थिंग्स कंज्यूम नहीं कर सकते हैं. ड्राई फ्रूट्स हुए, पल्सेस हुए, ये सब कंज्यूम नहीं कर सकते हैं. उसमें ही एक अलग सा नोट लगाया है कि जो राई का दाना होता है, द मस्टर्ड सीड, वो एक अलग टाइप का द्विदल है. मस्टर्ड सीड सिर्फ आपको कोरा खाना है तो खा सकते हैं. उसके अलावा इफ यू पुट इट इन एनीथिंग एल्स, नॉट ओनली सॉल्ट, इफ यू इवन इफ यू हीट दैट थिंग, इफ यू पुट इट एनी अदर थिंग इन योर लाइक फूड प्रोडक्ट, लाइक तो कुछ भी हो, तो वो द्विदल की कैटेगरी में आता है. और वो उसमें ऐसे जीव नहीं होते हैं. द्विदल का क्या रहता है कि द्विदल में आप ऐसे मिक्स करके रखो तो उसमें जीव नहीं होंगे, बट वंस दे गेट, वंस दे कम इन कॉन्टेक्ट विद सलाइवा, जीव उत्पन्न होना शुरू होते हैं, त्रस जीव. सो यस, इट्स ट्रू एंड इट शुडंट बी कंज्यूम्ड. मैं आपको शास्त्र रेफरेंस दूंगी.
या ओके ओके. तो और एक क्वेश्चन है, ओबरजीन क्यों नहीं खा सकते?
Aubergines is bangan, right? Bangans क्यों नहीं खा सकते? क्योंकि उसको लिखा हुआ है scriptures में, जब बनारसी दास जी ने 22 अभक्ष्य लिखे समयसार नाटक में, तो उन्होंने अलग से इसमें mention किया कि उसमें बैंगन नहीं खाना चाहिए. Okay, the host says that we can continue tomorrow. Actually, time exceed हो गया है, तो should we like can I carry on tomorrow?
Yeah.
Okay. And I'll give the Shastra reference tomorrow. Is it fine?
Yeah. You can. Okay. If you want to send it to me direct, you can get my number from Shital.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah, we will share the plus in the group. Thank you, Raj.
Okay.
Jai Janendra.
Jai.
Thank you, Mukti.
Thank you very much.
Thank you,
Thank you. Much appreciated. Thank you.
Jai Janendra.
Mukti, are you there? No.